Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will discuss three related concepts: vascular distensibility, compliance, and volume pressure curves. Let's get started. Elastic fibers, like elastin and microfibrils, make the wall of the vessels stretchy. So when the pressure inside the vessel increases, it expands. Or in other words, its volume increases. The distensibility is a fractional increase in volume for each millimeter of mercury rise in pressure. Before you get scared, let me tell you that physiologically, this is a less important parameter than compliance. And luckily, the compliance is simple. It's total increase in volume per unit increase in blood pressure. Well, basically, distensibility and compliance are different ways of measuring the same stretchiness. Compliance talks in terms of an absolute increase in volume with pressure rise, whereas the distensibility shows the increase in volume relative to the previous volume. Now, those who are still not getting it, this is for you. Take a small vessel that has high distensibility. With a unit increase in pressure, it expands by 100% from its initial volume. And take a large vessel that has less distensibility. The same rise in pressure expands it by only 10% of its initial volume. In relation to initial volume, the small vessels have shown more expansion. So we can say that the small vessel is more distensible. But look at the absolute volume increase, represented as an area of yellow color. It has increased much more in large vessels than in smaller vessels. So the larger vessel has more compliance than the smaller one. And in physiology, we are more interested in absolute or total volume increase than in fractional increase. If you understood that, let's talk about the distensibility of different vessels. Arteries have thicker and stronger walls, so even with a large increase in pressure, they don't distend as much. They are like tubes in tires. When you fill them, the volume rise is small, but the pressure rises much. In short, arteries show less increase in volume with the increase in pressure. Thus, they have less compliance. Veins, on the other hand, are far more compliant. At lower pressure, their wall gets kind of folded. With an increase in pressure, it opens up and starts becoming circular, so they can accommodate much more blood without much rise in blood pressure. Thus, veins have more compliance. It doesn't need any example, but we can think of veins as balloons. They distend more, even with a small rise in pressure inside. Thus, the veins have far more compliance than arteries. Now let's talk about the importance of this property. The distensibility of both arteries and veins serves important functions. In arteries, it allows smooth blood flow at peripheral organs. See, we know that the heart does not pump blood continuously. It pumps during systole and takes rest during diastole. Yet, the flow at peripheral tissues is maintained constant all the time. This is made possible by the distensibility of the arteries. When the heart pumps blood during systole, the arteries expand and accommodate all the blood. During diastole, when the heart is not pumping, this blood is mobilized. Thus, the distensibility of arteries averages out the pressure pulsations and provides smooth and continuous flow to the tissues. Without distensibility, this would not be possible. Coming to the veins, we have already seen that the veins can expand much more with minimal rise in pressure. This makes the veins a very good storeroom of blood. Collectively, all the veins in the body hold about 3,200 milliliters of blood at a pressure below 15 millimeters of mercury. We don't actually need this much blood in our veins. Rather, most of the blood here is as storage. When blood is lost, as in the case of hemorrhage, the blood from here is shifted out to maintain normal circulatory function. And if blood is received, as in the case of transfusion, the extra blood can be stored in veins. Thus, high compliance of veins makes them a blood reservoir. So this is how distensibility plays a very important role in both arteries as well as veins. Okay. Now, when I told you that the volume of veins changes as per needs, did this question come to your mind on how exactly these changes are done? Well, it's done by changing the tone of the vessel. This tone, in turn, is under the control of the sympathetic nervous system. So now it's time to learn about the effect of sympathetic tone on the distensibility of the vessel. Sympathetic stimulation increases the tone of the vessel. So at any pressure, less volume fits in the vessel. This is how the blood is shifted out when needed. This is important not only during pathological conditions, like hemorrhage, but also during normal day-to-day life. For example, when you do exercise, the pumping activity of the heart needs to increase to supply oxygen to the muscles. One way to do so is to increase the sympathetic tone to the vessels. So vessels get emptier and blood shifts to the heart. As the heart receives more blood, it pumps out more blood due to the Frank-Starling mechanism. This was about sympathetic stimulation. The inhibition of sympathetic output decreases the tone. So the vessels distend. This causes the storing of extra blood. So these were all the concepts that you need to understand regarding the distensibility of the vessels. Now the same concepts can be shown in a graphical form too. So let's see them in the form of a graph. This graph is called the pressure volume curve. As per the name, it shows the relationship between pressure and volume inside the vessel. This red line is for the arterial system. It shows that there is a relatively small rise in volume even over a large rise in pressure. For arteries, the normal set point is here. The volume of all the blood in arteries, including large arteries, small arteries, and arterioles, is about 700 milliliters. At mean arterial pressure of about 100 millimeters of mercury. This blue line is the pressure volume curve of veins. It shows that a small increase in pressure can cause a large increase in volume in veins. Its normal set point would be around here, where the volume is about 3,200 milliliters. This is the position of both the curses under resting conditions. Now, sympathetic stimulation increases the tone of the vessel. So at any pressure, less volume fits now. In the graph, it appears as a shift towards lower volumes. For example, look here. Under sympathetic stimulation, the same pressure holds less blood. Or in simple words, sympathetic stimulation has caused this much emptying of the vessel. On the other hand, inhibition of sympathetic activity produces the opposite effect. It decreases the tone, so now more blood can be accommodated at the same pressure. So the curve shifts towards higher volumes. This helps store the blood in vessels. So this was all about distensibility, compliance, and pressure volume diagram of blood vessels. Now let's have a quick summary. The elastic nature of the vessels allows them to increase their volume with an increase in pressure. Distensibility is a fractional increase in volume for each millimeter of mercury rise in pressure. And compliance is a total increase with the rise in pressure. Compliance is more important in hemodynamics. Arteries are distensible, but veins are far more distensible. The distensibility of arteries allows them to accommodate extra blood during systole, so smooth blood flow at tissues is maintained even during diastole. And very high distensibility of veins makes them the blood reservoir. When this blood is needed, sympathetic stimulation increases the tone of the vessels. This shifts the blood into circulation. Inhibition of sympathetic activity helps store the blood. And finally, if you understood all of these points, fuck the pressure volume diagram. It's just a boring way of showing the same concepts, unless you are really into graphs. Now, for sticking with me until the end, I have an interesting bonus point for you. The pulmonary arteries are 6 times more distensible than systemic arteries. But as they operate at about a sixth of the systemic pressure, they get expanded to the same extent. That's it for this video. It will be so nice if you shared this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.